So moving on to the next question. So two challenges that seemed very insurmountable when they presented themselves to you, and now you're over it. So what were those two big challenges in the journey of KissFlow be that you and your team had to overcome, and you cracked it, and then you're
I think there was a time which we believed without funding we cannot grow. But I think we proved that that is not the case,
Sure.
right? We were able to grow consistently, although, meaning people might think like, it could have done, we could have done faster or better with funding. But the problem is that is not the case. That's a different topic. We'll probably talk in a different thing. So one thing is we believe that we overcome the challenge of growing the company without funding.
Right.
That is actually one. The other challenge is whether we could sell to enterprise customers sitting in Chennai. Because most of the enterprise customers, there is a normal philosophy, a normal understanding. Rather, there's an industry understanding that if you have to sell to enterprise customers, they expect you to come there,
Physically be there.
physically be there, wine and dine with them, show them the demo, build the POC, suck up to them, and then get the contract, and then you do what, wherever they show the paper,
Say yes,
sign,
sir, yes,
say yes
sir.
sir, yes sir, salute to them, and all. It's not true. We have $250,000 contract. We have never seen the customer face to face. We have never even seen it, and they have never even seen us.
Right.
They basically start the product. They bought 50 users. They tried the product. They were like baffled with the product, and then they said, "You know what? This is awesome. Let's go buy 500 users." And then they said, "Okay, let's buy 1,000 users." Then they bought 15,000 users,
Right.
right? And all of that. And then when they're crossing 1,000, they'll say, "Okay, we need to sign a contract." Then we'll sign a contract, and then they look at then we use EchoSign, and then we sign, and then they transfer the money to us online. That's about
Sure,
it. So
sure.
we were able to do all of this sitting in Chennai.
Chennai.
So we don't have very very many people outside of Chennai. I would say 99% of our employees are in Chennai.
So you probably believed that you can do that sitting in Chennai, but did your team also believe the same? How difficult was it? Was it a change management for them? Or how did you get instill the belief in your team that, hey, we can do this? Because it's very easy to say, hey, because we are not there, you're not able to sell it. In the initial
Yeah.
days when you're struggling to get your first customers. So how did that?
It sort of happened a little organically, I should say.
Okay.
There was a little concern that we had that, we may not be able to sell to enterprise customers, but there is the feeling that maybe if we are there, we will be able to sell a lot
A
more,
lot more. Okay.
right? So there is that feeling, but it's not bad, as bad as we thought. So we are able to sell
Sure.
to it. So.
So one page I'm able to pull from that book of wisdom is like, keep your product entry level pretty basic that people can try without you
Yeah.
having to give them a presentation of how your product
Yeah.
works and
Actually,
give
we
it.
don't present at all.
Right. So.
We don't even, our sales team doesn't have a presentation. So customers have to sign up, and then they try the product, and the sales team says, "Okay, what are you doing? I'll show you how to do it and do it."
Okay.
They don't start with the presentation at all.
Right.
And then, "Okay, what's your problem? Here's how it works. Okay, you like
It's
it?
like a
Are
toy.
you
The child will just have to open and
yeah.
start playing with
Okay,
it,
now
right?
that you like it, why are you not
No
buying?"
instruction. Right.
So our sales process is very simple, right? You
Right,
don't
right.
start with the presentation,
Yeah.
because we put all information on the website: who we are, who are our customers, what is the case study. We don't see, most of the time salespeople hold on to all this information as precious knowledge in a presentation, and they present to the customers, and they think that is what their value is.
Value, yeah.
And we tend to put all of that out in the public domain,
Right.
so that people, customers, before coming to a salesperson, already knows, "Okay, KissFlow has so many customers. They are in 160 countries. These are the customers who are using it. This is a in oil and gas, they have 5 customers in the enterprise segment, and each customer has done this with this." All this information is available on the website.
Right.
So they don't have anything to ask a salesperson about us.
Sure.
That information is public domain,
Right.
right? Then the only thing the salesperson has to do is help them achieve their goal, which means it always
Perfect.
starts with the product.
Product, yeah,
Yeah.
okay.
Yeah.
So rather than a salesperson, it's more like a customer success specialist or a customer
We
success.
call them product specialists. So they are really good with product.
Right.
They know the product, and their job, I call them, see, sales is the most noblest job, and sometimes we treat sales as like a cheating job.
Yeah.
Like you somehow con the customer into buying the
Buying it,
product, right? And
yeah.
that's the last thing we would want to do.
Right.
And part of the sales onboarding process, we always tell sales is the most noblest job. You know why? Because in sales, you are matchmaking. You're matchmaking, customers have a problem, and you think you have a solution. Your job is to find out if the customer's problem will be able to solve.
Solve it, yeah.
If you're able to solve it, then you made the match.
Yeah.
If you're not able to solve it, then you didn't make the match and tell the customer Kislo is not the right software for you. And here is another company, I think, yeah, alternative, I think you should go.
Sure.
Right? Sometimes customers come to us and then say, we just want this form thing, you know, all that. We say, go use JotForm.
Yeah.
Right? Why are you coming to Kislo for just a form? You don't use JotForm. Somebody sometimes wants a survey. And Kislo is not a survey tool. They say, go use SurveyMonkey.
Yeah.
Right? So we don't take, just because a customer has come in, we don't try to convert that customer into Kislo, right? We have to.
So they have to don the true consultant's role. They have to consult and then sell.
Absolutely. Right. Otherwise, there's no other.
True. Okay. Yeah.